Hey guys, it's JP, and this time we are gonna do another video on how you can use the same exercise for different gains. This kind of video may help simplify your exercise routine and help you understand what you need to do to really maximize the gains or results you are looking for. A while back, I showed how to do this with the split squat. However, based on all the requests, I will be doing it again, but this time it is with the exercise known as the bridge. I made this kind of video initially to show that exercises and training routines don't have to be all that complicated or fancy. Rather, one of the most important aspects of an exercise routine is the intention. To reach your performance goals, it may be suboptimal to blindly follow and perform exercises that you've seen other people or runners do. A reasonable training routine when someone has a scheduled race months away is typically much different when someone is weeks away from the race they want to perform his or her best at. So instead of getting caught up on memorizing a variety of exercises, you need to better understand what you need to reach your goals. Based on this, you can find ways that stress the body in a particular way to elicit the adaptations you need. If you understand what you need to work on, you can pretty much use the same exercise with slight modifications to get the gains you need. Now, I talked about this before, but there can be different types of focuses you could aim for. I covered some of these in detail in a previous video, so I will briefly go over them here along with variations of the bridge that you can incorporate for that focus. One is an oxidative focus. This one is more about building tolerance and improving energy levels, so you can basically sustain certain levels of activity longer. When thinking about bridge variations, I typically utilize the single leg bridge hold. This is a great exercise that targets the hip, trunk, and core region, which is involved in stability and control around the region as you run. Basically, you get into this position and hold for a set duration. I typically aim for 30-second holds with rest intervals of 15 to 30 seconds. Another focus is strength. There are plenty of definitions of strength, but to keep it simple, I'm defining it as the ability to improve your muscles' capacity to produce force. A bridge variation I would use to involve this would be hip thrusters. Most bridge variations are body weight, but this involves a barbell. This is great as utilizing a barbell makes it easier to challenge the muscles to elicit strength gains. All you really need to do here is add weight to the point where it is working the area hard. I typically try to gradually progress this to a point where the person can basically only perform the 4-6 reps of the exercise for 4-5 sets to elicit strength gains. Now, the first two focuses are things I typically aim for in the first half of the training plan toward a race. However, when it gets closer and closer to race day, I start to focus more on power and elasticity. So I'll talk about these two next. When working on power, velocity is key. This emphasizes improving the ability to produce force quickly. This is something to consider as forces are produced quite rapidly as you run. This can actually be done with a standard single leg bridge, but the difference here is that you need to move as quickly as possible. Now, I will mention that while you have to move relatively fast to get these kind of gains, don't slack on form. Now, in doing this, I typically keep the rep counts low, which could be around 4-6 reps. However, it is important to remember to take longer rest breaks in between each set. If you are still not fully recovered from the last set, you will move slower, which may not provide the stimulus to improve power. The last one we will go over is when the focus is more toward elasticity and explosiveness. This may be something to consider, especially since running involves constant energy storage and release. An example exercise for this one is the single leg bridge hop. This is basically the single leg bridge, but with a bit of a twist as you are hopping. As I mentioned before, you want to push hard through the foot on the ground, but you also want to keep the time on the ground as short as possible. Similar to the last one, I typically keep the rep counts low, with longer rest break intervals to really make sure you are able to push as hard and fast as possible. And those are some ways you can use the bridge exercise to get different gains. I hope you all found this useful and will help with your training. I'd love to hear what you think, along with any questions you may have. And as always, thank you for watching.